husband is in the Dominican Republic. He would like a vaccine waiver. Does RAP visa assist in that process? Okay, so the short answer is no. The longer answer is, the short answer being no, we don't do vaccine waivers. However, the longer answer is this. If you, you can still do the process with us, and we can submit your waiver along with the petitions, no problem at all. However, what I'll say about the waivers, we see people now and then go down that path. Most people abandon that path simply because there's a cost. I don't remember the cost because we don't do these waivers, but and fees have all went up about a year ago. It was somewhere around $500 though. So what you have to do is apply for a waiver. It's around $500. I hesitate to say that. It might be $350, but I think it's gone up to around $500. See if it gets approved. So we see two classes of people and I don't want to offend anybody. I don't know you. And so certainly I hope I don't offend you when I say, when we've seen this question, we see a lot of people who want a waiver until they find out it's $500. It may still be denied and it may delay your petition. All of a sudden they decide to go ahead and get the vaccine. So what I would say is, if you have extremely strong views about not getting vaccine, then it's probably worth it to you. But if you're kind of on the fence about it, I would get the vaccine. It's gonna be the easier way to go. And I hate to delve into a controversial topic, but as far as I know, there's never been any positive evidence that these vaccines are harmful. So there you go. If you're on the fence, I would get the vaccines. If you have some strongly held beliefs against it, understand your petition is gonna take longer. You're gonna spend hundreds of dollars asking for the waiver, which might still be denied. Because we don't deal in the waivers, I really don't know what the approval rate is. Maybe it's high, I don't know, but I know it costs you money. And usually at the cost you money and will delay your petition point, most people back out of it and decide that, even if they feel strong about it, they decide, look, this is not worth it. I'll just go ahead and get the vaccines. One overriding thing I will say about these petitions is the CIS and the State Department, between them, they're processing millions of applicants per year. And anytime you're dealing with a high volume of anything, you get to the point where you look for anomalies, right? Most of them are probably okay. And if you're the guy or lady at the desk and you're going through dozens of these a day, you get in a pattern where you know what you're looking for, and the things that looked right and correct and normal tend to float quickly across your desk, and the things that stand out get pulled out and get a little more scrutiny. So when you start asking for waivers, which is certainly your right, understand that you now have put your petition in a different category. Not just waivers, but you have any anomaly, you've done this multiple times. If your case is not in the 90th percentile like every other case going through, you're going to get more scrutiny. As they say, the nail that sticks up is the one that gets hammered, or whatever the saying is. I'm sure I got that wrong, but so again, it goes back to your convictions on this topic. If you have very strong beliefs, then by all means stick to your beliefs or your concerns or whatever they are. But if you have any flexibility, I'd get the vaccines. It's going to make it's going to save you $500 or so, and it's going to go quicker and possibly save your petition even more scrutiny. Your decision. People do definitely ask for the waivers. People do get them, but I don't know what the approval rate is.